Today, we're going to talk about 5 uses of AI in sports. Welcome to 5 Minutes, 5 Ideas. I'm your host, Samanvay. The first use of AI in sport is to help coaches coach better. You might have heard of the movie called Moneyball. It follows the story of a baseball club, which is heavily under-resourced in contrast to its wealthier competitors. It is at the bottom of the baseball league ranking tables. Then the coach decides to hire a mathematician, who would be similar to the modern-day data scientist. The mathematician comes into the team and starts digging into the statistics that correlate to individual performance in the game. And he does this while keeping in mind that he needs to build a team, not necessarily buy the best player at the best price. And using maths, they assembled a team that went on to have a winning streak of 20 matches. Similarly, in F1, each of the F1 cars are equipped with more than 150 data sensors. An AI algorithm is then used to analyze the data from the sensors and allows the coaches and drivers devise better racing tactics. The second use of AI in sport is to monitor players' health to reduce fatigue and prevent the risk of injury. Recently, IBM partnered with the US Tennis Association to provide insights to the coaches about a player's health during the course of a tennis match. And it also helps them highlight exactly when a player needs to take a break. Similarly, a company called Precision Wear is engineering vests that can be worn by athletes equipped with multiple sensors. The vest measures up to 21 metrics that can be used to quantify an athlete's performance during a training regimen. It allows us to know exactly how fatigued the athlete is so that they can take the appropriate amount of rest to prevent any risk of injury. The third use of AI in sport is to improve player performance by playing against an AI. Recently, a company called DeepMind trained an AI algorithm by the name of AlphaZero. This AI algorithm became so good at the game called Go, a game that's known to be way more complex than chess. It went on and beat the world champion of Go in multiple rounds. Now, there's no denying that there's been quite a few AI algorithms that have mastered board games. And if human players end up playing these AI algorithms, they can be exposed to a variety of moves that has been thought up by the AI algorithm, thereby improving their own game and helping them perform better against human opponents. More recently, DeepMind has also created an algorithm by the name of AlphaStar, which is trying to master a complex strategy game by the name of StarCraft 2. Now, this game is a lot more difficult than other board games, but you can see a clear pattern here. Once you have an AI algorithm that can master all of these games that we're playing, it can inevitably help us in improving our own skills as humans. And I believe we're going to see a lot of these trends in other fields and not just sports. The fourth use of AI in sport is to liven up viewer experience. Recently, the organization that organizes French Open teamed up with Infosys, an Indian technology company, to create an application called Stats Plus. This application would calculate statistics on the fly regarding the performance of the tennis players in a certain match. These statistics will be ranked based on how likely they are to predict a particular player's chances of winning. The final use of AI in sport is refereeing. AI algorithms are readily used in sports such as football and tennis to augment the umpire's ability to make better decisions. In gymnastics, Fujitsu, a Japanese company, used a motion tracking camera to record the performances of all gymnasts in a given competition. And the algorithm in the camera analyzed each of the recordings to produce statistics on the type of moves the gymnastics were doing, which allowed the judges to rank the performances better. That wraps up 5 uses of AI in sports. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.